All right, let's do this. Epic Samurai versus Samurai. Just hope your general doesn't die.
It's one unit versus one unit.
Yeah.
You haven't noticed.
Of course, you have the. You right now. Even though the katana samurai have an advantage in melee and Yari samurai are weak against katanas, still, you don't want to run that chance that, you know, your general will die. And then the guys will be like, "Oh, our general died. We must flee like cowards." Running, 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 getting killed, and not fighting back.
Cannon shots. Those skipping cannon shots with the point total war. You know what I'm talking about. Where they skip on the ground, it kills your general the first volley.
And that's a Napoleon total war.
That didn't even hit me.
Yeah. And how does it hit, how does it kill the general necessarily? It killed the horse. The general might live. Did it ever cross your teeny little mind that the general might actually live?
I think the general's like, yeah, it's not gonna live.
One thing I do miss about the old Total Wars is that they no longer have a prisoner management, system, where you could actually, you know, capture enemy prisoners and, you know, what have you. Ransom them. Even though usually that ransom failed, still. It was fun to always then execute them afterwards. Execution in mass. Alright, go. You're not deploying a whole army here, Republican. It's just one unit. You just gotta press start. No, I gotta put the archers here, I gotta put the cavalry there. No, it's just that one unit. Apparently, your guys are confident. They're already starting with low morale. That's not good. Must be because they're the only unit. They don't have a supporting army behind them.
Probably. I believe in my units.
Oh, no, don't worry. According to the stats that I looked over Yari Samurai, they're supposed to actually have a weakness against katana-wielding units.
And I know that.
Yeah, and your katana samurai already have a +3 melee advantage on the Yari samurai. The Yari have, like, a melee of, like, 9 or something. Your guys
have
a melee of 12.
5?
Yeah.
It's mine's 5.
I don't know about armor. I think only armor like applies to like the unit in terms of like of missile resistance.
You know what? Screw it. I'm gonna see what the Yari samurai has. Heavy infantry. I'll need to go back. Spear cavalry. Spear infantry. Yari samurai. 6, charge bonus 15, armor 5, morale 10.
Yeah, trust me, you guys have the advantage.
Better morale for some reason.
It's probably that cavalry. They know that they're resistant to cavalry more. It's probably that.
Yeah.
Like I was actually doing a custom battle, and I had like 4. Bulletproof Date samurai. Yari samurai from the DLC. Against a whole army of Takeda cavalry, and the first time I played that battle, I won, but I almost practically lost all my cavalry units. And in the process, Yari samurai had survived, they would have earned like, I don't know, 6 chevrons from that one battle. So I redid the battle again, and this time I just charged all my Yari cav in front of them. I then dismounted some of my cavalry. Charged the Yari samurai, and then I had the rest of my mounted cavalry coming from behind and slaughter them. And well, the battle went much more better then. It was like ridiculous how their Yaris were just stopping them from, you know, dying.
It's bulletproof.
Yeah, not bulletproof.
Don't you have gun cavalry?
Yeah, I actually tried using Tokugawa gun cavalry against them, and apparently they are like somewhat they die less quickly from bullets. Except from the Shimazu handgunners. I actually put them against the Shimazu handgunners. I was like, alright, let's see how resistant to bullets are you with these huge hand cannons. And nope, they felt like little shreds of wheat. They're resistant to regular bullets, but not to bullets the size of golf clubs, of golf balls.
Oh, well, I guess he is bulletproof.
Yeah.
Maybe it's the heavy in disguise.
Yeah.
If the heavy was a Japanese medieval warrior. Well,
I really wish they'd increase the range. Okay, epic charge. Charge, charge. Run them. Double click. Yeah. Yes, we know. That general's in great danger.
Well, I guess
it's
kind
of hard to tell the difference between the both of them since they're both blue.
Oh, whoops, I paused the game by accident. I apologize.
Your general just died.
No, he didn't.
Oh, he didn't? I see a tombstone over the 3D portrait.
I think you're hallucinating.
You lost the general, didn't you?
Not that I know. They are faltering. So, I have 122.
Yeah, see, you're slaughtering them.
Why? Now, if these were Nagi Natsus, this battle might have ended up a little bit different.
Yeah, just a slightly more difficult. You'd still have the melee advantage, but yeah, it would have been a little more difficult.
Well done.
End battle.
I'm going to save a replay.
Why do that? I'm already recording this battle.
Well, for my own personal enjoyment.
Oh, that's true. One thing I hate about... I hope they, like, improve that later on, because, like, in Empire Total War, this glitch occurred. I don't know. It was, like, this serious issue where if I opened a replay file, like, for some of my battles, it would totally end differently than what I remember.
I've had that happen before.
Yeah, that totally sucks, because I had this one battle where it was the Ottoman Empire versus Russia. I had, like, a huge disadvantage, but I had the upper hill to my favor, and I totally slaughtered the Russians without, like, not even once did any of my units even waver. It was, like, the most beautiful battle. It was, like, a battle Hannibal Barker would have been proud of. And the stupid replay somehow corrupted it, and the battle totally ended badly.
I think the AI just became jelly.
Yeah, he was like, I sucked so badly, I'm gonna ruin that fun for you. And unfortunately, I did not have fraps back then. Nowadays, I have fraps, so I record that shit. It's like, oh yeah, you're gonna ruin it? Well, guess what? I have it on fraps. And to top it off, I'm gonna upload it to YouTube and publicly humiliate you before the world. How does that feel?
Smug jerk.
Let's see, should I build a stronghold that consumes 2 food? 5 to repression, to blah blah blah, improves rate which Bushido, blah, 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 unlocks an additional slot. Probably should, I don't really have that much around here. Yeah.
Yeah, you probably should build more fort.
Alright, more fort.
That way you can have 2 forts instead of 1 fort.
Yeah. 2 forts are better than 1. Let's see, encampment in 6 more turns. Man. I don't know, turns feel so much longer ever since they turned it from year to... from 6 months to just 3 months. Yeah. Because, like, an empire, it was always 6 months, you know. One year passed every 2 turns. In this case, with Napoleon and this, it's 4. So it's like, my god, turns feel so slow now.
I think because I know an empire... Napoleon Total War, you can go pretty far on the map. Even with infantry.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, here, with infantry, definitely, especially fire rockets, you can't go anywhere. Alright, let's see what my friend Alex.
Alright, construction complete. Finished post roads and station. Excellent. I finished the roads there, so I should move a little faster. Quartermaster report. More Ashigaru militia. Now can I please relieve that place of its taxes, please? Let's see, finance is okay.
Yeah, will he wake up in time tomorrow for philosophy class?
Huh. You're into philosophy?
Huh. I'm taking an introduction to philosophy class.
Uh-huh.
And I normally... kind of sort of don't go because Professor reads off the slides. And I just don't feel like waking up at 11 a.m.
Hmm.
My sleep schedule's totally screwed up ever since I entered college. I used to be after 10 o'clock, I would just shut off and get up at like 6 something. Now I basically don't go to sleep for midnight or 1, and I start being conscious at 9 a.m. College just screwed stuff over.
Okay,
like,
I cannot build anything.
You need to do something at 9.
Hanjo itashimashita. Alright, so I'm gonna do finance. I'll move that army next turn. Okay, first. Yeah, okay, blah blah. Repression is 18. If I move the army out, what happens? They're apparently still happy plus 3. Still, I think I'll exempt them from tax for now. Just to make sure. And I'll put these guys inside for the moment. Yeah, alright.
Your daimyo's pretty good.
Daimyo. Yes, I love being bloodthirsty. You better consider catching up here. Just saying.
Once again, I'm pretty sure my Boashigeru can't grow wheels and turn into go-karts with flamethrowers.
That'd be pretty epic. Go-kart flamethrowers!
That's actually a unit from StarCraft 2.
Oh, really?
Go-kart? It's alien, and it's basically a go-kart with a flamethrower. I love that unit to bits, and the driver is like a NASCAR driver.
That'd be the pyro's greatest dream in TF2.
I'll show you the video of what the unit guy looks like. Oh, I got something. Monk increase in rank. And a daughter is born.
Aww, a beautiful little girl.
Good girl, I need money.
Hopefully she'll grow up to be a young, beautiful lady who can marry one of my sons, and then they can get married, then they can fuck greatly, and then bear us a grandchild.
Or children, because they probably fuck like bunnies.
Little bunny okay. Children.
So I have two choices for retainers. I can choose a rock or a monkey. I'm taking a switch on this.
What? Hold on. What do they do? What do they do?
Okay, the rock from Fuji-san has plus 2 zeal when inspiring towns.
Uh-huh.
And the pet monkey, no, he's a Christian. Has plus 1 happiness.
I think you should probably take the monkey.
I just didn't know the rock was a retainer.
It's like, here's my retainer. It's a stone. Oh my god. It's like, meet my retainer. His name is Stony.
His name is
Rocky Stone. It's like, oh, that's a pretty epic name. His name is Rocky Stone. It's like, what does he do? Let's see. His first name is Rock, and his father and his mother are Mrs. Stone.
Sure, Mrs. Stone.
That'd be an epic name. I should totally tell that to somebody. If I ever meet them and their name is Stone, I should tell them, name one of your children Rocky. And train them to be a bodybuilder.
Hey. Hey, Dana.
I assume that was Mrs. Shredder.
No, that's just roommate's friend.
The
Chosokabe are making their legendary horse school.
Huh. Wonder how the hell the Chosokabe totally skipped their province of Kyushu and went over to the north.
Damn it, voice cracked. I have no idea.
I really hope the Wako pirates, they are not like the Mongols in medieval Total War, where they're just this faction that appears out of nowhere. They have you can't access their home territory, but they can still spawn it out of their invisible home territory and just bother you for the rest of their lives. And I hope they're like an Empire Total War, where they actually have a base in the Caribbean, and you can actually destroy piracy forever.
No, you can't. They just spawn out of nowhere.
I don't believe that.
They do. There's no home base. Just like the Christian traders.
Son of a bitch. I'm gonna have to deal with pirates for the rest of my life.
The only thing is, like, the Christian trader, they only come, like, once every 20 years.
Oh, really? So it's basically, like, what, once every 80 turns?
Yeah. Basically, they don't come around that often.
Hmm. Of course, it's so we're so goddamn far away. I bet you they're probably coming more often, but like 3/4 of the ships that try to come here are either tsunamied or pirated.
Something like that.
Yeah. I mean, Marco Polo himself, who 400 years ago, what do you call it, when he went to Mongolia and, you know, went back to Venice, what do you call it? He, like, I think, like, out of all his ships, like, only one or two made it back out of, like, a total of 13.
Or it could be Magellan, who didn't live to see his journey.
Recruitment. More Ashigaru in here. Don't trust the populace for one second.
Populace is just jealous.
Yep. You have your little monk accompanying you.
Hey, that monk makes me go farther.
He does.
6%.
Let me religiously inspire you.
Well, there is the inspire ability. I'm just not choosing not to use it. So, hopefully I will end my turn.
Alright.